And this specially goes for the 2024 aspirants.
Because
don't
of the
try to read new things. There's
fair.
Hardly any time.
Very true.
It's a 46-page chapter in Lakshmikant that everyone, I think, leaves for the end to revise.
Mm.
But it's a very important chapter. Mm. Begin with the assumption that you do need mocks and that you need a lot of them.
Mm.
And that's when you made the video and I got to know that it's happening with everyone. So where paper hota hai. So I, first of all, you don't have that much time that day to panic.
And Shashank sir ka inhone kafi particularly dimag khaya hai.
Be very well researched before you start preparing for this exam.
Hello everyone, and welcome again to the YouTube channel. And you might be seeing this elsewhere also. Today we have with us Aditi Yadav, who has been one of UPSC Prep's main students. She was associated with us for interview guidance also. And Shashank sir ka inhone kafi particularly dimag khaya hai. And I think she has scored one of the highest marks in the interview this year. She secured also a rank of 194. And I think she'll get IAS.
I'm hopeful, yes.
Most
amongst
likely.
IAS, I
yeah. So, welcome Aditi.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for having me.
How are you doing?
I am very well, thank you.
So, Aditi, tell me a little bit about your UPSC journey. Matlab, shuru kyun kiya tha? Why did you start? Why civil services?
Sir, so to talk a little bit about myself, I am an eco graduate from Delhi University, both bachelor's and master's.
Okay.
After that, I was working in Bombay for almost, I would say, around 15 months.
15 months is a nice way to put it.
Yes, 1.5 years, you can say.
One and a quarter.
Yes, one and a quarter.
Mm.
And that was in advisory with one of the big fours. That was a very nice experience. I had a great team, great mentors, everything. I moved back home for before the COVID lockdown happened.
Oh,
right. And then I think a little bit of it was also that I had a lot more time to think about things. And then that's when I started thinking that what it is that I really want to do and where my skills, I believe, could be best used.
Okay.
And then had discussions with the family on my own research also.
Mm.
And that is how I thought that I should give civil services a try.
Okay.
So
when did you start like sort of preparing, or which was your first attempt? Which year?
My first attempt was 2021.
Okay.
This is my third attempt.
Mm.
But in the first attempt, I wasn't very prepared. So I would say that my proper first attempt,
this is such a UPSC thing to do. Ki, matlab, I think mera bhi pehla first two attempts, I had failed prelims miserably.
Matlab,
by large margins.
Right,
yes. So like my dad was very interested in ki nahi beta kar lo. So he's like, nahi, serious to pehla hi hai.
Exactly. I don't know what it is. I think that's why something that I want to say very specifically is that listen to what people are saying.
Which people?
People who have been through this journey.
Okay.
That can be anyone.
Hmm.
Someone who has tried, someone who has cleared, both people. But be very, very, listen to them very seriously. Because I think I wasn't like that in the first attempt, and that's why I missed on some time. But it's okay. Everything's a journey.
I think that is also something that sort of comes after you've been humbled.
Yes, definitely. And if it is
Were
humbling,
you somebody who required humbling?
100%. I am definitely someone who required humbling.
Mm.
So it's all been a journey. But I think now that we're here, we always think that, you know, people who are preparing right now, they should have the most clear and clear knowledge, decision-making knowledge about the whole process, whether that's the syllabus, whether that's what goes on in your mind, everything. And
so if you have to say that, like, what is the one thing, just one, which is something that is absolutely non-negotiable for somebody who's preparing for civil services exam, what would that be?
I would say discipline.
Fair.
Discipline,
yeah.
More than anything. So yes, that is when I started preparing, and this is my third attempt.
Hmm.
My optional was political science and IR.
Why not economics?
A couple of reasons for that. First of all, there was some time lag between when I completed my master's and I started preparing. So I would have had to start from the start almost. Secondly, Delhi School of Economics is a very different sort of an institution. It's
okay.
it's very quant heavy, it's very academically oriented. So the overlap itself between the UPSC and this wasn't that much. What I just studied in D school wasn't all that much. So I wanted to take something that had a lot of overlap with other subjects and was
Did you have sustainable. A process of sort of, you know, identifying ki kaun se option hai ya PSIR pe, like, you know, you found that interesting from the start?
I always was interested in IR, so that was there. I was also considering sociology for a while for the simple reason that a lot of people scored in it. That was the only reason. But we settled on PSIR because something that was interesting about PSIR to me is that first of all, my interest, even if I didn't know about anything, I could still write something.
Yeah.
And secondly, the material. The gold standard for PSIR that is there in the market right now, it's a very concise set of 8 books.
Shubhra ma'am ka?
Right, yes. So, and those are very easy to understand also. Mm. So, and that decision paid off. Both in
How
PSIR.
How much did you score in PSIR?
I scored around 125 and 145, so not that much, but I scored...
Nee, 270 is a decent score.
Yes, I mean, there are people who scored almost...
So, see, again, this is something that I have generally found with... a lot of people are sending mark sheets. So, they're like, you know, GS1 mein mera kam ho gaya, GS3 mein mera zyada ho gaya, ye ho gaya. Matlab, main kaha ki bhai dekho, individual subjects, it's great because it helps you optimize your prep. Ki bhai, haan, matlab, you know, this is where my effort should go. But when you're looking at the marks, I think it is the broader categorization. Ki bhai, general studies, mein, am I scoring 400 plus? Because in each year, there are differences. In 1 year, there'll be like, you know, GS3 ka average up gaya hai, that everybody's scoring 130, 140, 150.
Right.
And the other year, it'll happen when nobody has crossed 100 in GS3.
Yes.
So then, like, you know, me fixating on ki mera isme number nahi aaye, that part I feel is not that much. Which is why, even for optional, I have just like a very basic grading scheme.
Right.
Ki bhai 200, 280 to 300 ke beech mein aapka aaya, that's a very good score. 300 plus is like absolutely phenomenal. Right. 320 is exceptional.
Yes.
Because like, you know, wo ek ya do log ka hi aa raha hota
hai. Yes.
260 to 280 is theek hai, fine. Obviously fair. Scope for improvement. 260 ke neeche aa rahe ho, to matlab tumhara selection ka chances dheere dheere phir wo kam hota ja raha hai.
Right. And PSIR had a lot of overlap with GS2 also.
That's true.
Where I also scored well. So
how much did you score there?
112, I think.
That's pretty good.
Yes, compared to math, the GS1.
What was your total for GS1, 2, 3, 4?
GS1, 2, 3, 4 was I did not score well in GS1 and GS4.
Total kya?
Total, I don't remember. I can see and tell you, but it's less than 400.
Okay. I think you compensated a lot for it by the stellar interview marks.
Yes, yes. 100%, 100%. And between us, I was expecting a lot more in mains. I don't know what happened, but okay, whatever.
But that is, I think, ye wali cheez main hamesha maine sochi hai, maine iske bare mein kaafi, matlab, you know, I've tried to introspect on it. I've given 4 mains. Matlab, I should have had some understanding of how much I'd score.
Right.
I've always been off the mark.
Yeah.
Matlab, it's just, matlab, at least maybe it could be something that I have not been able to grasp because I have known, I think Rahul Balhara ke saath main baat kar raha tha. He secured 494 last time. So he was saying ki nahin, maine jitta assume kiya hai ki bhi, matlab, after every sort of attempt, mera jitta bhi assumption tha, he scored like plus minus 5. So I'm like, theek hai, there are people who do that, but like very difficult. But
very difficult, yes. So I couldn't do that.
Hmm.
But that's why I think PSIR is a very comfortable optional to read, to spend time with.
Yeah.
Material is there. So those were some of the reasons for choosing PSIR.
And those are like pretty solid reasons also. Kyunki, like, I think the first thing that you started with, that this is a subject that you can read.
Yes.
Even when you're bored and even in that sense. So, agar wo subject aapka optional banta hai na, to, you know, life bahut asaan ho jati hai because bahut ragda hai otherwise.
Exactly.
So, this is your third attempt. Did you clear prelims in your first two?
In my first attempt, I did not clear prelims. Mm. And after that, re-strategized entirely.
Mm.
But then, in my second attempt and my third attempt, I cleared prelims.
Okay. So, what changed between your first and your second and third attempt? Matlab, what did you figure out about prelims?
Right. So the biggest change was between the first attempt and the second attempt.
Hmm.
Second and third key strategy was kind of
pretty
similar.
Similar.
Yes. So a lot of things changed and I will talk about them step by step.
Hmm.
One was the past year analysis.
Evacues, yeah.
Do not outsource that. You can, you, I really
What do you mean when you say outsource?
That you can use sources only to corroborate what you find.
Mm.
You cannot use it
as the only
way. The only way.
Mm.
It will not be etched in your brain. You will not understand what's happening. So spend 10 days just analyzing the PYQs.
Yeah.
And the thing is that anyone that's actually done that will know that there are certain areas that require a proportionately that much focus on those areas.
Yeah.
So, for example, rivers in geography are very important. Every year, there's a question from either rivers or lakes.
Mm.
Likewise, for polity, there are certain chapters that are much more important than other chapters. So, that is something that I did. Spent a lot of time with PYQs to understand what this exam is about.
Fine. So, like, when you say you spend time with PYQs, what exactly are you doing with PYQs? In the sense of, जैसे अगर मैं 2023 की बात करूँ तो देर थ्री मेजर टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस राइट वन यू हैव द असर्शन रीजन टाइप क्वेश्चंस वन यू हैव द डायरेक्ट आंसर क्वेश्चंस कि भाई मतलब नो ऑप्शन नो नथिंग जस्ट क्वेश्चन एंड चार ऑप्शन एंड द लाइक अदर वन 50% ऑफ द एग्जाम वाज दैट यू नो वन ओनली टू ओनली थ्री ओनली तो डिड यू बिकॉज अब वो जो थर्ड कैटेगरी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस है दोज वर नॉट अ लॉट ऑफ PYQs बेस्ड ऑन दैट राइट एंड दैट वाज द सरप्राइजिंग बिट सो डिड यू चेंज योर प्रेप anything in the sense of between your second and third attempt ya matlab main janna ye chah raha hu ki wo PYQ ke sath karna kya hai PYQ analysis sab janta bol de rahi hai but like what is analysis
all right so in geography so say that's Indian geography and across years if I'm seeing an entry that is rivers or lakes
it means ki exactly. Rivers and lakes is important
it's an important Likewise, in polity, a chapter that I think is very important is the parliament chapter. It's a 46-page chapter in Lakshmikant that everyone, I think, leaves for the end to revise. But it's a very important chapter because there's so much content in that chapter. So there are questions from that chapter every year. And once you do this sort of analysis, you will have an idea of where to focus your efforts where to not, very importantly, where to not spend a lot of time. So that is something that I did. Secondly, mocks. I think when I began preparation, I thought ki if I read enough, 15, 16 mocks would be okay. And that strategy did not help. If you're someone who has either not been able to clear a prelims yet or if it's your first attempt, I would recommend front loading the mocks.
Paper ka wait nahi karo, abhi, up front.
Yes, start doing them now because you won't have that much time to do 40 mocks at the two months before the prelims because you have to revise those mocks also.
So, yeah, it's I think the people who are giving this year prelims, they have what I think 50 days? Slightly less than 50 days.
Yes. So you, but
52 days. Today is the 24th.
It's on 4th June, right?
It's on 16th.
16th June.
Mala itta out of it ho ki bhai matlab you know I am selected. I don't care when prelims is.
I don't know what's happening in Israel now. I don't. Second day I stopped reading the paper.
That's a good thing. Kyunki I think वो जर्नी में कहीं ना कहीं हम वो वेट भी कर ही रहे होते हैं कि भाई कब खत्म होगा ये
बट द वे आल्सो मेरे फोन पे देयर आर नो एक्स्ट्रा एप्स देयर इज नथिंग एट ऑल एंड नाउ सिंस आई हैव बीन सो आउट मेरे को सुबह पेपर पढ़ने का मौका नहीं मिलता तो अभी न्यूज का सोर्स ही नहीं है कुछ आज ही सोच दे आई शुड डाउनलोड
सम
ऐप यू नो बट एनीवे यस बिगिन विद द अजम्पशन दैट यू डू नीड मॉक्स एंड दैट यू नीड अ लॉट ऑफ देम बिगिन विद दैट अजम्पशन
हाउ मेनी डिड यू गिव
I gave around 35.
Okay.
Which were and proper
full
mocks.
Full length test.
Full length mocks. Yes. Achha,
and did you also give section tests on top of it?
I did, yes.
Okay, how many of those?
Maybe around 15, 16.
Okay, so about 50 mocks in all you had given.
Yes.
And this was starting from, let's say, ki if your prelims was end of May, so you started all of this from Jan, Feb, March, when?
I would say late December itself. Because I like to space out. You cannot retain that much information in a smaller amount of time.
Fair enough.
You know?
Mm.
So, begin with the assumption that you don't need mocks.
Mm.
I think the way... And I do believe mocks have a lot of credibility to them. Coachings do know what they're doing. I believe that. I think it's an unpopular opinion, but it has worked for me.
Hmm.
So I do believe that people out there do know what they're doing.
जस्ट अ स्मॉल असाइड ऑन दिस, इट्स नॉट लाइक कि इंस्टीट्यूट्स को नहीं पता है क्या कर रहा है क्या नहीं कर रहे हैं, बट बहुत बार क्या होता है ना कि देयर इज द एक्सपेक्टेशन दैट कि भी यूपीएससी लेवल के क्वेश्चंस हमें मिलेंगे. दैट इज आई फील नॉट द राइट एक्सपेक्टेशन टू कैरी इनटू अ टेस्ट सीरीज.
यस,
टेस्ट सीरीज इज अ टेस्ट ऑफ योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट, नॉट कि भैया हम तुमको एग्जैक्टली पेपर वाला क्वेश्चन दे देंगे, क्योंकि वो कहीं नहीं होता है. मतलब हाँ. तो आप जेई में चले जाओ, नीट में चले जाओ, कहीं नहीं होता है.
नहीं होता है. right. और बोलना मतलब कैसे ही होगा, नहीं, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल ओनली. बट मॉक्स आर जस्ट दैट, दे आर मॉक्स. दे विल प्रिपेयर यू फॉर समथिंग, बट द मेन एग्जाम इज द मेन एग्जाम. सो anyway, the reason I came to that was that I took one whole set of a mock from the coaching, because I think the way they design it is that all of the syllabus is complete.
Which
broadly.
Test series or which mocks did you take?
I had the 25 tests pack from Vision, and then over and above that, I whatever I could find online. So I did attempt a few from other coachings also, whether that's Inside, IS, Baba, Forum, UPSC Prep, whatever. I
generally,
could find
mixing and matching is a good idea.
Mixing and matching is a very good idea, I think, because I think you had a video one point. Everyone was scoring less in a test series. I don't know if you want to put this in the final video, but
nee,
Vision.
That's fine.
Everyone was scoring less on those tests, and I was so like, what is happening? I'm reading so much, I'm studying so much, but I'm just not scoring. And that's when you made the video, and I got to know that it's happening with everyone. And that was very relieving to me. After that, I started doing other coachings, mocks. And that's when my score went up a little.
So what was your average score when you're giving Vision ke mocks and versus like where did it progress to? I'm not saying kis mein kitna aaya, just like what, like where did you start, where did you end up?
I started at, I would say 50.
Okay.
My score was 50.
And then like how long did it take you to reach the peak?
2-3 months. But
and what was the peak?
My peak was 125.
That's
and
a pretty solid score.
And in the real prelims also, last year I had a 111 and this year I had a 80. So I do...
वो 111 क्यों बोला बीच में, मतलब कि you're just trying to build credentials.
But this time it was harder also, not 80 is still like 6 points above the cutoff.
That
so
is fine. I'm not saying ki, I'm not taking anything away from you over there, but like I just feel
you
111.
Yes, but yes, the reason I mentioned it was that I did think that something that I was doing was working, because you know the range was also comfortable.
So when did you start getting this confidence that you know, okay, matlab jo main kar rahi hu wo kaam kar raha hai?
I'll come to that. So mocks, very important to give, but even more important to analyze what's happening
very
in those
true.
Mocks. I came to a system, and this is something that you had spoken about, and this is just an operationalized version of what you had spoken about.
Lovely, Mala, please do share.
Yes, so we can again set a screenshot that I'll send you here.
Right, will do.
Amongst all the questions that go wrong in your mock, however many, either you've skipped or the questions that you've
gotten wrong,
divide them into two parts. One is conceptual, one is factual.
Okay.
Now, amongst those questions, calculate two metrics. One is how much you could have scored on the current mock by intelligently
guessing
or attempting or leaving questions, very importantly. And second, how much you can score with the current set of material that you have. Which will...
How are you calculating this?
Okay, I'll tell you. And see, for example, these are all conceptual questions, static knowledge, and these are factual, right? Now, something like Kemu range, it is geography, and we've all read it. The reason I've gotten it wrong is that my revision is not enough. So things like this, states that didn't join the 1857 rebellion, it's
fair.
There in spectrum. We've read it many times. If we're not understanding the fundamental rights resolution by Jawaharlal Nehru 1931, this is all there. We are reading it multiple times. If the reason is that, like, you know, we're not getting it right, it's probably because our revision is lacking. So don't, and this especially goes for the 2024 aspirants.
Because
don't
of the
try to read new things. There's hardly any time.
Very true.
Focus your efforts on revision. You've already read enough.
नहीं, so मतलब इस ये वाला part कि projected marks जो आप calculate कर रहे थे, कि मतलब based on conceptual and factual, you're calculating projected marks.
Right. Yeah.
Is this a, like sort of it's a feel good metric? I feel.
It is, but don't you want to do that? So the idea was that there are two things. Do you already have enough knowledge? And the second is, do you want to gain more knowledge? It is a projected marks, but the thing is that I would want to be in a situation where I'm like, okay, if I revise enough, I should be good.
So you're sort of building in a incentive mechanism into your test analysis,
yes,
which is sort of ki bhai agar maine acche se revise kiya hota to mere itte aate.
Exactly, yes.
Theek hai.
Because I really think that even in the main paper, a lot, these are not out of the world questions, especially for subjects like polity. They are all from Lakshmikant. The idea is to firstly for me, scoring low on mocks repeatedly was very demotivating. So
Malab, it is for anybody, yes, not just you.
Yes. So I had to do something to understand that where was I going wrong. Are these mocks that hard that I'm not able to do them? And the question is no. You already have the material. There is something, if you change it, you'll be good. So that was the reason for me to calculate these two metrics. And
what
also,
was the other one? First metric to ye tha?
That how much you can score on this mock only by either leaving questions or intelligent guessing or other things like that. So, you know, if it's about a...
So, if we have to operationalize intelligent guessing, what would you call intelligent guessing?
Right. I think there's a fair bit of content on this, but... And I have also taken from other people's content.
Nee, so, see, this is something that you have to sort of accept and understand that we do not come into the world as blank slates.
Yes, yes.
Like, tabula rasa, even though it may be such a, like, you know, enticing theory to believe in, we don't.
We don't.
We bring in a lot of context just from our genetics also. And then, obviously, we learn so much from our environment that whoever I may be today, I'm not a product of just me.
Right.
Nobody, I think Arnold Schwarzenegger put it best when he said, I am not a self-made man.
Yeah.
You cannot be self-made once you've reached at any stage in life, because to get there, you have to have the support.
Yes.
For you, it might be YouTube videos, something, that thing, whole thing. But like, that is the whole point that I see of the UPSC journey, which I find quite fascinating. Jab tak tum us cheez ko synthesize karke apna version nahi bana rahe.
Right.
Because like, ye jaise conceptual factual chal raha hai. So, I've been talking about this.
Right.
But you took it a step further, because for you, that marks was the motivation.
Yes.
Right? Ki bhai, matlab, main conceptual sahi karti, to mera itta aata. That was what drove you.
Yes.
Matlab, I would never have recommended to anyone for the very simple reason that they'd be confused by ki bhai, ye nikalna kya hai. But that's the thing, ki you personalized it to your own self.
Yes.
In
yes.
what worked for you, and that's what the beauty of this is.
Yes. So, for example, ancient, I'm not good at guessing in ancient history questions. So, I should not guess them. That's fine.
Awesome.
If I don't, attempt 87, it's okay if I attempt 83. But over a period of time, when you start seeing these trends, that what are the kind of questions that you're repeatedly getting wrong.
Fair.
So, I would then, in my later mocks, not attempt ancient only. So some of those things, I think, were very important. So, this was a game changer for me. I do...
What were your sort of strong subjects?
My strong subjects were polity, economics, because that was my subject, and even geography. Modern is also...
What were your weak subjects?
My weak subjects, ancient history, science and tech, because I never...
Why?
Because I never covered the basic material for science and tech. By the time prelims would come, I would be out of time each time to cover it. So that was only PT 365 for me. So these were some of the weak subjects. But yes.
So going on into the analysis wala part where you were saying you noted down your mistakes, conceptual, factual, and then you tried to give yourself a projected score.
Right.
And now you've also talked about analysis jab aap kar rahe ho isme to revise kaise kar rahe ho, because this is what I see, that you have a OMR sheet,
yes,
revision guide tester, and like iske peeche you've sort of done the revision for this itself.
Yes.
So this is your entire notes from this test. Is that what
this
it is?
This is just the analysis of all. These are all the questions I got wrong. Now, how many of those questions I could have gotten right? I'm not even, you know.
How many of them are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, 15, 20, 22 something. 22 conceptual mistakes.
Yes.
How many did you attempt? You attempted 83. And how did you get 40 that?
I attempted 83. And then I got 63 right and 20 wrong. So 112 I got. But I saw ki okay. And now isme 112 hai, to isme scope hi kam hai increase hone ka. जिसमें 50 आ रहे हैं उसमें और भी ज्यादा स्कोप है.
सो पॉसिबल मैक्सिमम यू कुड हैव गॉटन इज 115.
यस, इन द करंट मॉक विद द करंट लेवल ऑफ प्रिपरेशन.
ओके,
इफ आई जस्ट स्किप्ड अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस 83 की जगह अटेम्प्ट 80, यू कुड हैव गॉटन मोर. व्हाई डिड आई टेक सम अननेसेसरी.
सो दैट इज आई थिंक दैट्स अ वेरी वेरी गुड थिंग दैट यू हैव डन. कि एट द एंड ऑफ एवरी टेस्ट यू आर सॉर्ट ऑफ मेकिंग दैट प्रोजेक्टेड कैलकुलेशन. बिकॉज़ बहुत सारे लोग पता है क्या करते हैं कि जस्ट किसी ने बोल दिया कि 90 अटेम्प्ट करना, 95 करना, वो लगे हुए हैं. भैया तुमको आता है नहीं आता ये तो देखो. मतलब यू हैव टू हैव दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ अवेयरनेस एंड असेसमेंट. तो दिस ब्रिंग्स मी टू अनदर प्रीलिम्स रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन व्हिच आई वांटेड टू आस्क. हाउ डू यू डिटरमाइन व्हाइल यू आर सिटिंग फॉर अ टेस्ट और व्हाइल यू आर सिटिंग फॉर प्रीलिम्स वेदर दिस पेपर इज हार्ड? मतलब क्योंकि कहीं ना कहीं आप कितना अटेम्प्ट कर रहे हो विल बी डिपेंडेंट ऑन कितना हार्ड है. इफ इट्स अ इजी पेपर यू वुड वांट टू अटेम्प्ट मोर.
यस, आई थिंक aspirants still have a range in their mind that they want to attempt, and that is just speculation. So before going into the paper, I was like anywhere between 75 to 85.
Okay,
last year I actually attempted around 75 and I got a much higher score. Then this year I attempted more and I got a lesser score. But yes, so some of that is practice, and I think that thing that if it's an easy or a hard paper should only come towards the end, especially for people who are sitting for prelims. Only decide after you're out of the hall whether it's easy or not. And also take some solace from the fact that if it's a hard paper, the cutoff will come down. So don't get panicked in the moment. If it's hard, it's so hard for everyone.
Did you ever get panicked exam days where? Because I remember, like in some of the earlier mentor calls, you used to panic a lot.
In my first, in the second and third, no. In the second and third attempt, I was fine.
What changed
compared to the first? My preparation enabled
you to, like, you know, reduce panicking, bring it under control. What were the things that you did? Did you do anything or was this just a natural progression?
It was mostly natural, sir, because wo subah paper hota hai. So I, first of all, you don't have that much time that day to panic. You have to get going. And secondly, I think my sister always used to accompany me on Sunday, so she would make sure that my mind is elsewhere right before entering. So you can try talking to someone you like, or just I think that is something you have to develop. Yoga, I think, is a good thing. I didn't do it because I didn't feel like I needed it. But yes.
So, like, how important has been family support for you?
Extremely important. I think I can't even begin to tell how important. I think I'm very lucky that I was staying with family. My family is based out of Delhi and I got to stay with them. It was a big, big help. In all sense of the term.
And like I think we don't sometimes appreciate that enough because wo ek basic level pe tumhari jab zindagi sorted hoti hai, so then like you know it's easier to give you 100% in whatever it is that you're doing.
Yes.
And for some reason a lot of people feel ki bhai Delhi jaake bahut padhai ho jayegi, Delhi jaake kuch nahi hota.
Nahi.
Zaruri nahi hai.
Especially Delhi jaake I don't think that's true at all. If you're somehow in Rajendra Nagar and disciplined, maybe hota hoga. But imagine someone who has to travel 1 hour and all. So none of that I think is true. But I know other people also who have stayed at home and benefited from it. So the support of family is extremely crucial. And when we say family, I mean a support system. So that could be anyone.
It could be your partner, whoever.
So just to have a support system around you. So even if you're in Delhi, make sure that you have your group of friends around you that motivate you. You motivate them, that kind of thing.
Did you have a group of friends that was doing this sort of a thing?
not a lot of my friends preparing for UPSC, but I had my friends who would make sure that whenever I wanted to take a break, they were available.
Okay.
So in that sense.
No, so that's a pretty solid support system in an
office. Yes, 100%.
So anything else that you want to share about the prelims stage of the preparation?
My big takeaways have been that get your basics right.
Mm.
Everyone always says that. Analyze the papers. Give a lot of mocks.
Mm.
If you see consistently scoring well on mocks, then maybe you can take a step back.
Mm.
But don't assume that you will score well. If you've given 15 mocks, 20 mocks, and you're scoring above 90, fine, take a step back.
What do you mean when you say a step back?
Reduce the frequency.
Okay.
Or maybe you don't need to attempt, you know, 70 mocks then.
Fair.
But if you're scoring 50 to begin with, and then you somehow think that right before prelims, you're going to be able to score 90 on a mock, maybe it works for some people, but don't assume that it'll work for you. Do not make that assumption.
So, like, what would you recommend to people who are giving prelims in the next 50 so days? Last moment, pe, what were the things that worked for you?
Revision. Lots of revision.
Mm.
Don't waste time in making any more notes.
Mm.
The material that we have in the market is already pretty concise, whether that's a PT365 or any other document. Highlight in the document. Keep revising over and over and over again. Revise your mocks also, because the way they are designed, they are designed to cover the syllabus, so revise your mocks also. Focus on your mental and physical health. It'll be fine.
And if you want to recommend something for the people preparing for 2025, what would that be?
Start with the papers.
Previous
year papers, yes. Mm. There is no getting, there shouldn't be any getting. I mean, there's all, you can do whatever you want to, nobody is forcing you to do anything, but there should not be any getting around analyzing those papers. Especially in the last 2-3 years, since the pattern has changed so much, definitely analyze them.
So, this is the controversial question which is going on, which is sort of, ki, you know, will kya bolte, optional hatega, nahi hatega, all of these sorts of. I feel that, personally speaking, I don't put a lot of store by these questions. But a lot of people are very, very interested in if optional hat jayega, nahi hatega, kya hoga. What do you think is going to happen?
I'm actually not aware of this. If it has happened after 4th April,
it is absolutely awesome. Because that is my take on it in general.
Don't waste time in all these Twitter conversations and all. Absolutely not. You should have your guiding mentors. I had you, Arushi and I, my sister. We always kept a tab of your YouTube channel, your Twitter handle, but not a lot other than that. Don't fall. I mean, just be very mindful of how you spend your time and energy.
Yeah, I think that is also somewhere a base level problem hoti hai, that people are just not mindful.
Yes. You have to be mindful. We are telling you, please be
mindful.
It's
not just like her telling you, me telling you, anybody telling you.
Yes.
It is just, time is the only resource that you cannot exchange back.
Yes, but the cost of preparation is very high for all of us. Mentally, I don't
That's
even
true.
Mean monetarily. I just mean mentally.
Mentally,
so,
emotionally.
Emotionally.
Yeah.
So
sometimes physically also, if you have your kamar kharab kar liye.
Exactly. So, yes, always have your guiding forces, your mentors.
So, moving on to mains. What did you do for mains? What changed between your first mains attempt and your second mains attempt?
For me, what changed was, again, focusing on mocks. I am someone who believes that mocks help me. If I'm scoring well in mocks at any of the three levels, I will score well in the main paper also. Mm. So I gave a lot more mocks. I finished the paper. So that was also something that changed.
Mm.
Then again, a lot of content building always has to happen. You cannot use shortcuts without content. So you have to have the material to write.
Yeah.
So that kind of material enrichment also happened. Varied sources.
Mm.
Having expert sources for each
subject,
for example, and I'll come to some of this when we talk about the interview, but for agriculture, for example, there's a columnist, Dr. Ashok Gulati, who writes in Indian Express very frequently.
Mm.
So he was my go-to when I wanted to understand something.
So I think he's a director with the Indian Council of Agricultural Research.
I'm not sure, but I think so.
But
yes.
He writes from plate to plow. That's his you know, syndicated column. Mm. It comes across newspaper. Aap Hindu pad rahe ho, Indian Express pad rahe ho, doesn't matter. You'll see Ashok Gulati.
Right. So to have those kind of the rich content and then to use that rich content in a limited time. I spoke to mentors also, even for example, the ethics paper. I spoke to a vision mentor that told me some very like doable tips that could help me. So, you know, write a certain way or try to. So basically in an ethics case study, instead of talking about six problems that are there in the case study, focus on the top two, three, which are the most important. So things like this. Basically, mentor support has proved useful to me.
So like, how do you prioritize this? Because a lot of times, what happens is that identify karne mein people are fine. People can identify, but they cannot prioritize ki bhi sabse important kya cheez hai, kaise hai.
Sir, I think
like for example, जैसे जोशीमठ का अगर हम बात करते हैं तो जोशीमठ में लैंड सब्सिडेंस हो रहा है तो दिस कैन बी अ वेरी इजी केस स्टडी राइट कि भाई आप डिजास्टर रिस्पॉन्स फोर्स का मतलब यू द पर्सन लीडिंग द फोर्स डाउन देयर एंड व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज कि भाई पीपल आर टायर्ड दे हैव बीन इन अ डिजास्टर एंड समबडी स्टक इन डेब्री एंड लाइक सडनली व्हेन यू शो अप तो देन लाइक यू नो there is an altercation that breaks out with the locals and they're just not interested they're very angry so how do you deal with it well this is the situation
Right. So I think the nice part about an ethics case study is there's mostly no wrong answers. so you can bring your own perspective to it. But then what I used to do was that pick up case studies from last year's, like previous year's papers and discuss it with whoever I could find around me.
Okay.
So, you know, this much is a case study. Anyone can read it in real time.
Very good deflection, but like we'll move on.
Yes, sorry. But
no, but that's fine. And that is, I think, one of the skills that you also need for the interview. Ki sometimes, you know, maneuvering the conversation.
Yes.
But anyhow, mains mein matlab kitna effort aapka gaya tha into note making? Matlab how much, matlab how long did you spend? Like what kind of notes did you make? And like give us some nitty gritties.
In my second attempt, so which was my first mains, a lot more time went because in the third attempt I already had some of that.
Let's material. Say for example, let's take a topic ki separation of powers. What kind of notes would you have made on that particular topic? Because separation of powers is something that's very directly mentioned in the syllabus.
Right. Actually, separation of powers, I don't remember. So, separation of powers as a topic was also a part of ASIR. So, I did
that's
not
true.
Have to do a lot.
Okay.
If you want, we can talk about something in GS3 because there
Fine.
Is no overlap there.
So, then, internal security, mein agar hum aate hain, and internal security, mein you have something, let's say, Jammu and Kashmir situation. Yeah, Jammu and Kashmir, chodo. Cyber security. So, what kind of notes would you make on cyber security?
Right. I would begin at the baseline by just writing verbatim what was given in the syllabus, UPSC, cybersecurity, UPSC. Now there would be a few PDFs that Google would show me. I would take from those PDFs. So things like basic definition of cybersecurity, what are the various facets of it, what are the agencies in India dealing with it, those kind of things. And so this is all the static bit, like cybersecurity, static today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow will stay the same. And then comes the current bit of it.
Yeah.
So have there been any incidents of cybersecurity? I would try to note them down from the news. Also, something that I did this time around was that for all topics, I would write committees on cybersecurity. In India or reports on cybersecurity in India and then note them down. So I had almost, I would say, 40 committees on different things.
Okay.
And then over a period of time, when you start revising them, they are something that's easy to mention.
If you have those notes, so like how much time did it take you to build these sorts of comprehensive notes? Because what you're talking about is a very comprehensive piece of, I think one or two pages may you would have been done.
Yes.
One or two pages mein cybersecurity is pretty much covered. Anything ever they ask you for cybersecurity, you'll be able to cover.
Yes, mostly.
So, like, how many such pages did you have? What was the entire sort of GS 1, 2, 3, 4 ka notes ka? Like, how many pages was that?
I used to use Notion.
Okay.
So, Notion is very, very helpful.
It's very convenient.
Very convenient. But in terms of, I don't know if I have the number of pages, but
approx.
Time. Okay. Hmm.
50, 100, 150, 500, something.
Maybe around 30 per paper. So around 120 maybe.
150 roundabout.
Yes, yes. Around 150.
And what was the length of your notes for sort of your PSIR?
PSIR, yes. So PSIR, I used MAM's
material
as the baseline and everything else was a value add. So she also has videos on her channel, the subscription that I had, where she talks about questions. And her method is that she'll take a question and then discuss everything around that question. So whether that's India, America, so she'll discuss a lot about India, America. So I used to make notes out of those. So PSIR ke liye, I would say it was half a register. The
that's just the current affairs thing,
yes,
because the rest of it was already
yes,
jo ma'am ka notes tha, wo pretty much you were using directly.
Yes, there were mocks also, so you can.
And what about essay? How did you practice for the essay?
I loved preparing for the essay. I think it's one of the best subjects you could prepare for.
Why?
Because if done correctly, it's very enjoyable in my experience.
Yep.
So in mains, I would recommend everyone to really fall in love with reading editorials. So you should have fun reading those two pages. And from those two pages, a lot of your essay material will come from GS 1, 2, 3, 4, the factual bit of it. The story bit of it, how to make it interesting, or the anecdotes bit of it, those will come from the editorials. So every time I saw a nice anecdote or a story, I would just write it down in my notes. So I did not do an education specific this thing, that thing. If it was in the editorials, I would write it. And that was a little helpful for me because I think recently essay topics are becoming more general. So I was fine with the fact that my anecdotes also were general. And add to them quotes also. Any quote that I could find anywhere that I liked.
Where did you find the quotes?
One was in Indian Express only on the top right corner of the editorial. And then mocks. So the essay mocks, the answers to those mocks would often have very nice quotes.
Okay.
Goodreads, if you want to spend some time there.
I think I had curated a number of quotes on Goodreads.
Yes.
And after a point, I think after a point I stopped, I should start doing that again.
It's very nice to just go back and still read them once in a while. So that, so I would say my essay prep was very organic because what I did last time was try to make it overly scholarly and I didn't score that well. This time the idea was to keep it simple, the idea was to keep it coherent and just that.
How much did you score in the essay?
120.
That's a pretty good score.
Yes.
So, like mains ka ye ho gaya, answer writing, matlab, as you said, ki bhai mocks was something that you were very heavily dependent on throughout this phase also. So, how many tests would you say you wrote for mains?
12 full length.
Okay.
So
and any part?
Each,
section test, no section test.
I didn't have enough time. So, if 20, 25 people, if they have enough time, then why not? They can try doing that.
So, you're saying 3 for each paper you wrote?
Yes.
And,
3 for EGS 1, 2, 3 and I think 4 mocks for essay and around for PSIR again I didn't have time so I could not attempt all of the mocks. So there the number was rather small but I still read the mocks to understand how to write it. I did talk to mentors which helped me I feel. So whether Sashank sir, I spoke a lot to Sashank sir. So very very easily fixable things. They can help you point and guide. I would say that whoever we, the whole point of a mains mock is to also have it corrected by someone.
Who knows?
Someone credible that you trust. Reach out to the people who are correcting those mocks to understand how you could have done it better. I think across coachings, people are more than happy to do that, to get on calls with you, to help you understand what could have gone well. So do that. I think a lot of the times I fell short of doing that in my previous attempts because it's a logistical hassle, you can say, to schedule those calls, to get on those, to incorporate that feedback. It does take effort, but I think it's worth it.
So, like, if you had to sort of run us through one of the conversations that you had with Shashank sir, kya like, problem thi and like what was the suggestion given in that case?
Right. So, in one, I think it was a GS2 paper, and we were talking about it, and sir pointed out that how I'm using way too many words, like I'm being way too verbose for a 10 mark question. I needn't be that verbose. I should use pointers and things like that, pointers, diagrams. It'll save on time, help me complete my paper, and it'll be easier for the person. Hopefully easier for the person who's also evaluating it. Also, introduction and conclusion. So you need to set the tone in the introduction that you've understood the question correctly. And that should not take like 6 lines. It should be 2-2.5 lines. You need to convey that you have understood the question. On the closing note, even if you don't have any statistic ready to go, you would still try to think about what someone has said about it. So, you know, someone famous may have said something about it, whether that's the judiciary or the or whatever. Try to mention that as said by this thing, that thing. So instead of having a very, very generalist sort of a conclusion, or mention like articles of the Constitution in the conclusion that we must strive to this,
I think DPSPs are a very good place.
DPSPs and
aur bhi koi milta
hai aur bhi koi milte ho to. But the idea was that don't just leave it like that. Too generalist is not a good idea. No, it should be a good answer. If it's an average, don't depend. We strive for good answers. If we strive for good answers, we may get average answers in the main paper. So this was a typical call with sir. Then, and yes, then I incorporated it, and the results.
So this time around, when you got the call for the interview, so what was the feeling? How did you react to it? And like, did you feel like you were making progress? Yeah, matlab kya lag raha tha? What was the feeling?
Definitely, sir. I think the first feeling was relieved. You're just relieved that, okay, you have a call. And I had worked very hard. It was a very conscious effort in mains. And when that paid off, there was a slight feeling of, okay, something's going right. Something that we are doing is going right. And that's always a good feeling. And yes, it was, we were all quite hopeful also. So it was a very nice feeling.
So like, how did you prep for the interview? What was your, because so far as I know, and this is something that Shashank sir has been telling me and KC sir, they were both present in your mock interviews. So what they told me was that there was a drastic change from your first mock to like now scoring 2-1-2. And what has been that journey? I'm sure there were a lot of learnings for you. So what were some of the most, how would you say, basic mistakes that you were making? And what do you think worked for you in the final interview?
Right. My interview was way later. It was in, it was literally the second last day. So I believe that I, in my head, I was lax in the beginning for the interview prep. As it got focused and as I had a date in hand, it was easier to concentrate those efforts. But some of the things that worked for me, two things. One, even in terms of material, one is the DAF-based material.
Take care.
So that's everything about you, your background. The second is the current affairs. So worked on both levels, and then after materials is also the way you present it, the practice of that. Let's come to the material first. Because in terms of presentation, I'm again going to talk about mocks a lot. So in terms of
This is one of the good things ki very early on in your journey aapko at least ye cheez ek bahut clear ho gayi thi ki bhaiya dekho mere ko test dene se chamakta hai. और मेरे को टेस्ट देना है इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ यस नो क्या बिकॉज अब जैसे बहुत सारे लोग आते हैं तो वो इंटरव्यू के टाइम पे भी मॉक इंटरव्यूज दे रहे होते हैं दे गिव 15 मॉक्स हाउ मेनी डिड यू गिव
आई गिव अराउंड 8 आई
गिव इट्स अ लाइक रिस्पेक्टेबल नंबर गिवन दैट यू वर इन अप्रैल क्योंकि तब तक बोर होके दे देता है इंसान इतने तो
यस सो आई वुड एक्चुअली रेकमेंड दैट समवन हुज इंटरव्यू इज अ लिटिल लेटर ऑन इफ यू कैन स्टिल गिव अ फ्यू मॉक्स इन द बिगिनिंग दैट वुड बी अ गुड आइडिया
फटका पड़ेगा तो खुद ही पढ़ाई करोगे.
Exactly. It'll either go well and you will understand what you're doing right, or you'll know where to work. So either way, I think it's a good idea to give mocks. And I did do that. My first mock was, I think December 28th or something. And my interview was in April.
मतलब तब तो date भी नहीं आई थी, तो you didn't even know when it'll be.
Actually, not December 28th. Maybe it was January first week. Because date आने से पहले I don't think they conduct also.
नहीं नहीं.
They do.
This time around they did because 2nd Jan was the first interview.
Oh right right right. So it
so
was
might have been December also.
Somewhere in that 1 week. So yes, in the first few mocks I saw that I could speak, but I was not concise. I was not, I was being very verbose, very conversational, I guess I am. So that also my subject specific knowledge.
Economics or PSIR?
Both. So people who deviated from their graduation subjects for the optional subjects have two subjects to prepare. Was lacking in both, and then it was a whole process where we worked on that. Now coming to material, the static bit of it, the DAF bit, there is an initiative by Abhishek Saraf sir. He spent some time with you, and then his understanding, like explaining to you what are some of the potential areas from your DAF that could...
DAF analysis, jisko bolte
hai, yes.
Abhishek Saraf was doing it with An Academy, so far as I remember. Or was he doing by himself?
I think it was, I'm not sure, but I think it was with Raj Malhotra. I am not sure.
Could be.
I am not sure. I spoke to him. And then his team gets back to you with a PDF, a comprehensive PDF of the various kind of questions from each entry of your DAF. So, for example, logistics was an entry on my DAF. So then the team will, in that PDF, there will be like some 12 odd questions on logistics entry, which you can prepare. For someone like me who's, I was appearing for the interview for the first time, that was very helpful because if you sit alone, there's not more than 4 or 5 questions you can think about.
Did you use any of the AI tools?
Yes, I was going to come to that. Yes.
Because this, I think we also faced this sort of, there were people who came up to us and said, ki aisa kuch PDF hame de do. And the first thing that came to my head was ki matlab yaar ye GPT tumko khud hi karke de deta but like theek hai tumne mere ko bola now I will use GPT for you is what is going to happen.
I would just hope that if it's a coaching institute and people at the institute they would take something from the transcripts also which
definitely
ChatGPT might not be able to.
ChatGPT ko tum transcripts feed kar sakte ho.
Yes, if you
so like for example again don't get me started on this because this is a whole other area. There's something called AutoGPT. AutoGPT are basically self prompting models of GPT. What you do is you give it a task. You don't ask it a question. You give it a task, it will prompt itself. It will take on whatever services it needs from the internet and it will get your task done. Obviously, you know, the efficiency and the kind of tasks that can be done are limited at the moment. But given the fact that we have internet of things wala integration hamara chal raha hai even within the next 5 years, it's going to be just like that. Haan bhai, GPT.
Yes. So, very good idea. And I actually did use ChatGPT.
How?
Yeah, I will come to that. But yes, so this PDF was a very good idea. So, if someone can either make a PDF for their, themselves or source it from somewhere. That would be very nice, I think. I don't know. I was a little scared. Logistics pe, I didn't know ki how reliable ChatGPT was. I don't know.
Again, I think it's a very similar idea as what you did for mains, which is ki bhai aapne wo jo keyword likha wahan pe and keywords se related top PDF aage, unme se aapne jo framework hai wo utha liya. So similarly, what ChatGPT, see, again, ChatGPT is not a search engine. And this is the mistake that a lot of people make is that they start using it as a search engine. Give me mujhe logistics se sab bata do. Nahi batayega.
Right.
Rather, use it for finding that framework.
Yes. Another thing that we can, I think we're trying to say the same thing. Use ChatGPT for questions, not answering those questions.
Yeah.
Don't use ChatGPT for answers. Or if you're using it, make sure you corroborate it with
definitely.
The natural source.
Definitely.
But we can definitely use ChatGPT for the questions. I used it for my hobbies. So something like interior design was one of the entries in my hobby.
And you had like a lot of varied hobbies.
Yes.
Tumhari bahut sari kuch kuch hobbies thi, which is like sort of if you can defend them, it's a great thing. But a lot of the time, jo kuch log aisa, you know, fake hobbies likh dete hai. So that is I don't matlab,
yes.
When I was giving an interview, to us time pe somebody had written horse riding. मैंने कहा क्यों लिखा, तू घोड़े के आसपास भी नहीं गया है, तूने लिखा क्यों है ये?
इट वाज
लाइक कि इंटरेस्टिंग लगेगा भैया, इंटरेस्टिंग पे सवाल पूछेंगे, फिर तुमको आता नहीं है तो क्या करोगे?
सो इंटीरियर डिजाइन पे चैट जीपीटी अच्छे से वी यूज्ड, इट गिव अ लॉट ऑफ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चंस एंड फॉर सब्जेक्टिव थिंग्स जहां पे फिगर्स आर नॉट इन्वॉल्वड आई यूज टू आस्क चैट जीपीटी टू गिव मी द आंसर आल्सो. सो सस्टेनेबिलिटी इन इंटीरियर डिजाइन फॉर एग्जांपल, things like that. So
fair.
We use ChatGPT also. For current affairs, it was entirely papers. No magazines, nothing. Entirely papers with a very heavy focus on explained and editorials again. Along with
did
the
you read one newspaper, two newspapers? How many newspapers did you read?
Along with the general newspaper, which for me was Indian Express, I also had Mint for economics. I would have liked to have one for IR also, but that was mostly Google search. So two papers I read end to end. That was very, very helpful to read it and then to make your notes out of it. So for example, agriculture, early on in the interview, a lot of questions about the whole MSP thing were being asked. So on agriculture, you should know it well. You should have a pro for MSP, a pro case for MSP, a con case for MSP, and then which side you're leaning.
Fair.
All questions. So that was purely the papers that will suffice. Something that I do recommend and that I did do was also have a source of videos. Because they are interesting, you can, and there's also
what kind of videos for what?
For me, there was an economic scholar, Dr. Radhika Pandey, and she does a video with print. It's called Macro Sutra. It's a series. So there's a periodicity in these, so you can, you know, constantly
keep coming back, yes, ek review hota rehta hai.
Right. And it's very interesting to hear their thoughts. They bring that level of depth, which unless you try very hard on your own, it's not, it's very difficult to reach. And it's interesting to watch. Videos are, I think, very a lot more interesting for most people than reading long texts. So that for IR, I found Dr. Swasti Rao's videos on YouTube only, and I used to follow her. So if you can find your subject specific experts and then listen to them at regular intervals, I think that's very helpful from the main point of view also.
Fair enough. And like interview mein mocks, obviously you've given a lot of them. You've done these sorts of general prep for GS ki bhi aapne ye videos dekh rahe ho, and then DAF ka aapne us taraf se kar liya hai. So like, for example, the thing that we touched upon at the very start, there was like a great gap between your final appearance and the first mock that you gave. So what were the major shortfalls in your, how would you say, prep bol lo usko, ya bhi approach to it bol lo, but what do you think you were missing, which you then eventually found, because 212 is like an exceptional score in the interview.
Right. Sir, I think a plan was missing. I did not have a list of XYZ things to be done. And that's fine. At the beginning, you wouldn't have that list. It's only once you're in the process, you will have that list. I started preparing around January for the interview. And after that, I had that list.
Okay.
So both, all things, that's the material, the actual discussions, the trial discussions that I would have outside of the mock rooms also, in general, whoever's around me, okay, so this is a problem. Even if, you know, we were sitting in a car in this traffic on the road, what can we do about it? And then to talk about it and to monitor ki how many words you're using. There you need to be very concise. So if you're sitting at the dining table with your friends or your family and you're discussing something, make sure that you're discussing it in an interview framework. In concise.
Madhab, if I can sum it up, you were very aware of this entire process throughout, I think, 4 months. And like, if you're aware of it throughout that period, then naturally you will have a lot of improvements.
Yes, I the only one of the advantages that I had was was that my interview was later, so I could follow the transcripts. I had time to build on it. So yes, I just hope that these kind of videos will help people who will appear for the interview this time.
Right. So, and, एक जैसे बहुत common मतलब you know random problems लोगों को रहती है. So the people, this is primarily the people who haven't even started prep. They'll be like कि मैं interview में मतलब you know मेरी English ठीक नहीं है, मेरा ये नहीं है, ऐसा नहीं है, तो मेरा interview में number कम आएंगे क्या? So like how useful do you think is you know proper enunciation or having a large vocabulary and those sorts of things ki jo language ka skills hai, how important are they for the interview?
Sir, proper enunciation I think is important,
mm-hmm.
but I don't think that we need any Shakespearean level of vocabulary at all. The idea, and this is of course my only interview, so this is all what I felt in the interview. The idea was to convey what you were thinking.
What you've experienced, what you...
Yeah. So it was never... I don't think it is about using fancy words at all. It is about using limited words in the right manner. And that very well in any language will come with practice. So...
That's true.
concentrated practice will help. Whoever you can find around you. Or actually one of my friends had this idea also that record yourself.
Yeah.
You know, ask yourself a question and record yourself and then see that how many words you're using, what is the quality of your answer, things like that. But just one more thing that I would like to bring up, and this was again a lived experience. It's easiest to have a good interview, I think, if you're honest.
Yep.
It's easiest to have a good interview if you're honest about everything, right from DAF. And this is a very common advice. Everyone gives it to everyone, that just be honest on your DAF. It's not about being interesting. It's about being honest. So.
But that's the thing, no? Okay, a lot of people feel that if I be honest, I'm boring.
That's a misconception. I think that's a misconception. You have to preserve your authenticity because... And the way to preserve that authenticity would be by being honest. So
very true, but again, मतलब I think a lot of people, like for example, मेरे DAF में भी ऐसा होता था कि फिर 5-6-7 hobbies लिखी हुई, मैंने chess भी लिखा है, boxing भी लिखा है, running भी लिखा है, ये भी लिखा है, ये भी लिखा है, ये भी लिखा है, कुछ कुछ लिखा है. So like when I went for a like sort of DAF analysis, so they would tell me कि इतना सब कुछ क्यों लिख दे हो, सवाल आ जाएंगे. मैंने कहा मैं तो चाहता हूँ इधर से सवाल आए. But that's the thing कि ever since the Netflix and the Amazon Prime era, people have stopped pursuing hobbies. And once you stop pursuing hobbies, so then there is not a lot to write over there. Because I say ki one of the hobbies that you had written was analyzing some thriller mysteries or something, something, something.
Yes.
So that was like a very niche thing to do. Ki bhai, matlab main movies dekhti bhi nahi, main analyze karti hu. Right. So like somewhere or the other, even if you're doing Netflix, so there is always that scope ki bhai, matlab what is the genre that you're watching? Right. Is there a particular director that you're following?
Yes.
Look into it.
Yes. So think about those things because all of us are doing something in our idle time.
Yeah.
We're doing something. It's about putting that thing into words. But yes, I even in my real interview, as I think is with most people, you don't know something, that's fine. Just be honest about it. That's all.
I think that is sort of for every stage of the exam. कि मेंस में भी प्रीलिम्स में भी नहीं आता तो मेंस में मतलब जबरदस्ती के दो पन्ने मत भरो. मतलब आधा पेज पे अपना जो जो कुछ कुछ आता है लिख के चलो आगे, टाइम बचाओ एटलीस्ट.
राइट.
सो कमिंग टू लाइक सॉर्ट ऑफ द क्रक्स ऑफ द कॉन्वर्सेशन व्हिच इज समथिंग दैट आई जनरली हैव अ चैट विद एवरीवन, कि हाउ डिड योर मेंटल हेल्थ वेरी थ्रू आउट प्रिपरेशन? मतलब व्हिच वाज द हार्डेस्ट स्टेज फॉर यू मेंटली एंड लाइक व्हिच वाज द इजीएस्ट स्टेज फॉर यू एंड लाइक over the years, how has your mental health been impacted by UPSC prep?
Sir, the hardest part was the second attempt. I had not cleared one attempt already, so that there was that pressure. I was putting in a lot of hours and not seeing mock numbers, so that was affecting a bit of it. Then mains didn't happen. So that was all very, very, I would say, difficult. And I wasn't sure how to regulate it back then. So it spilled over to the people around me also, you know. So it was a stressful time. But in the third attempt, even before anything happened, even before prelims happened, it was peaceful.
Why?
I think you just reach that level. It's a cycle. So you're stressed enough and then you realize that, you know what, it'll be fine.
Mm.
Either way, it'll be fine.
Mm.
I think we take yourself a little less seriously.
Mm.
It's fine. Take everything a little less seriously. People are not thinking about you as much as you are thinking about you.
I think that has been sort of one of the biggest realizations of my life also. Because like when I started making YouTube content, XYZ, putting out stuff on Twitter, I was very conscious.
Right.
And like, because, you know, everything that you're saying is being judged one way or the other. And then I realized ki, kar lo yaar.
Exactly. Exactly.
Mm.
The only thing is be true to yourself.
Mm.
Rest, things will hopefully fall into place. Whatever that place might be, they will fall into place. And yes, realize that if this journey is hard for you, it's not easy for the people around you also. They are supporting you. It's fine. Be kind to yourself and be kind to everyone that is a part of this journey. So, yes, that is
key. I think that's a good way to go about it, because a lot of people, what they also do is ki, we have a lot of things going on in our head. And since we have difficulty like sort of verbalizing it, so we're not even sharing it with the people who are close to us. And since we're not sharing it with them, and then we are frustrated ki bhai inko samajh kyun nahi aa raha hai. तुमने समझाया नहीं, तुम समझाओगे नहीं तो समझ कैसे आएगा. तो लाइक टेकिंग द पीपल हु आर द क्लोजेस्ट टू यू, बी इट योर फ्रेंड्स, योर फैमिली, योर पार्टनर, वट एवर बी द केस, टेक देम अलोंग. एंड फॉर दैट ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू हैव सम क्लैरिटी इन योर ओन सेल्फ, बिकॉज अदरवाइज इट्स अ स्ट्रेसफुल थिंग.
या आई थिंक द क्रक्स वुड बी टेक एवरीथिंग अ लिटिल लेस सीरियसली. And I obviously, we don't mean to sound preachy sitting on this side now, but
I'm not saying this, you're saying this.
But I have been on both sides also.
Yeah.
So, and things were a lot easier when I was like, you know what, if it has to happen, it'll happen, it's fine. So I've tried both ways, to be very serious about it, to be very stressed about it, and that didn't help. So enjoy the process.
Fair enough. I think in the end, like life is also sort of, you know, about enjoying the process. Because if you're not enjoying the process, so banta nahi baithta nahi hai, and like tum frustrate ho jaoge, tum diwar pe sar maroge, diwar pe sar maar ke bhi you'll realize ki bhai ab yaar kuch nahi ho raha hai. And then you'll be like, bhai acha ab dusri diwar dhoondte hain.
Yes.
So, summing up the conversation. If somebody is starting UPSC prep, let's say like this video is the first video that they see. What would be your advice to that person ki bhi kaise taiyari shuru kare?
My advice would be that listen to a lot of videos like this.
Hmm.
Then do your own research and start with past your papers. That is all. These three things.
Fair enough. And
listen to people in the profession also.
Hmm.
So senior,
for example?
For senior bureaucrats, senior diplomats, what they have to say about the kind of work, the
where can somebody access that?
Speeches, I think. There's a lot of interviews.
हाँ मतलब ministry का जो secretary का interview आ रहा है वो सब type चीजें. So मतलब I think that's a very good suggestion actually.
Yeah.
Which not a lot of people give.
I was reading a blog recently and it said that a lot of the time we're working on speculation. We don't know how lives will turn out.
Yeah.
We're working on expectations. A good idea. A good way to see how your life will turn out in the next 25 years is to see how people in that field are doing.
Yeah.
You are not different from the average person in the field. Don't think that, you know, in
you
either direction.
Don't consider yourself the exception.
Exactly. Don't consider yourself the average person. So,
what is the, let's say, joint secretary doing now?
Yes.
And what is the additional secretary doing?
Yes.
And if you like somehow become IAS at the age of 22, then what is the cabinet secretary doing?
Yeah. So that might help you understand a lot of things. So I really like that advice. So now
it's a really good advice too. And like, I think somewhere or the other, it was inherent tha, but I think you verbalized it very well in the sense of ki bhai jab tumko yahi nahi pata hai ki karna kya hai. और फिर तुम ख्याली बुलाओ बनाए जा रहे हो तो कोई मतलब नहीं उस चीज का.
Yes, I think a lot of people around us start UPSC just because how famous it is. It UPSC
shouldn't be less famous.
No comments only I have.
क्या है कि मेरी बारी आई तो less famous करवा दो.
And no
that's fine, fair. मतलब उसमें ऐसा घबराने की क्या बात है, क्योंकि देखो कहीं ना कहीं what I feel is कि the over glorification of this job, because in the end it's also still a job, is for one simple reason. ये over glorification यहाँ पे simply है कि this is that like sort of I always like to call it the Indian dream. कि अमेरिकन ड्रीम क्या है, अमेरिकन ड्रीम इज अ वेरी मतलब सॉर्ट ऑफ कल्चरल कॉन्सेप्ट दैट दे हैव, कि भाई मतलब यू नो यू कम टू अमेरिका, यू वर्क हार्ड एंड यू कैन मेक इट बिग इन लाइफ, यू कैन बी अ मिलियनेयर. इंडिया में मिलियनेयर से फाइट नहीं है, यहाँ पे हमको समाज में इज्जत चाहिए. एंड यूपीएससी करते ही वो ऑटोमेटिक तुमको समाज में इज्जत मिलती है, इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ वेयर यू स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम, व्हाट यू डूइंग एक्स वाई जेड, बिकॉज देयर इज इवन सच अ थिंग एज कि लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल व्हेन यू गेट मैरिड, राइट, तो देन कास्ट बिकम्स अ बिग इशू, राइट, इंटरकास्ट नहीं करना, ये नहीं करना, वो लाइक दिस कल्चर हैज प्रिस्क्रिप्शंस. द कल्चर सेट्स असाइड यूपीएससी क्वालिफाइड कैंडिडेट्स एंड देयर इज अ सेइंग व्हिच गोज आईएएस इज अ कास्ट इन इटसेल्फ.
Right. Not heard it, but so, yes, it so, sounds right. Sounds
right. So that's what I've felt. Ki that is one of the reasons why this exam is sort of that social free pass. Ki tumne hazar paap kiye hain, tumne ye paper nikal liya, wo piche ka saaf. Okay. Best of luck. Go on.
Right. That will take a longer time to change, I think. But
it won't change probably. Matlab in our lifetime, I don't know. Maybe if they, you know, sort of discontinue the service.
I don't know. But know very well what this exam, what this job entails and what this exam entails. It shouldn't just be a, I do actually think that UPSC shouldn't be the default. Your default should be something else, and if that's not working out, then think about it. For the majority of people, have a backup. But, think about a backup.
I think that is exactly opposite of what the majority does in reality.
Because it's, I think a lot of it is herd behavior, a lot of it.
It is.
So, yes, be very well researched before you start preparing for this exam.
And I think those are all very wonderful suggestions. Thank you, Aditi, for your time. And it's been a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you for your guidance all throughout the journey. Also, you and UPSC Prep, all of
Happy
your team.
Happy to have helped.